time and plotting time. Requirement for the practical are pricking needle, filter paper, thin capillary glass tube, and stopwatch. Let us perform bleeding time by Duke's method. Principle: a deep puncture on skin is made and length of time required for bleeding to stop is recorded. Procedure: set the stopwatch at zero. Make a sterile finger prick about 3 to 4 mm deep, which allows free flow of blood. Immediately start stopwatch and note the time. Apply a filter paper on pricking site. It is zero time. Apply the filter paper on pricking site at every 30 seconds in a sequence. Stop the stopwatch as soon as bleeding stops. Duration of time is from the first drop till no blood stain on the filter paper. Conclusion: count the drops starting from drop taken at 0 second to no blood drop. You can see here we have counted from 0 to 5, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 multiplied by 30. So our bleeding time is 30 multiplied by 5 is equal to 150 seconds. Let us perform clotting time by capillary glass tube method. Principle: a skin puncture is made and blood is taken into capillary glass tube. The length of time that it takes for the blood to clot is known as clotting time. Procedure: make a sterile finger prick about 3 to 4 mm deep. Introduce one end of capillary glass tube next to the blood drop for the blood to flow into the capillary tube. While doing this, hold the other end of the capillary glass tube at lower level and record the time. Break about 1 mm of the capillary tube from one end after 30 seconds and check for the fibrin thread. If the fibrin thread is not seen, repeat the procedure at every 30 seconds till fibrin thread appears. This is the fibrin thread. Calculate the time, and that is our clotting time. Note that clotting time is always longer than bleeding time.